How would scientists tell the world if they found evidence for alien life? Some prominent astrobiologists think we will most likely find compelling evidence for extraterrestrial life relatively soon. NASA Administrator Bill Nelson said in an interview that intelligent life may exist elsewhere in the universe, beside Earth. If you have a universe that is 13.5 billion years old, it is so big, there is another chance for another sun and another planet that has an atmosphere like ours. So I think we're going to get some indication that there's intelligent life out there. According to SETI, the probability for finding alien life somewhere in the Milky Way is high, based on a number of studies showing that our galaxy contains countless Earth-like planets that orbit sun-like stars. The Drake equation suggests that multiple extraterrestrial civilizations could exist in our galaxy alone. But where is the evidence? The fact that none has been found yet doesn't mean it doesn't exist. The question whether we are alone or not remains a hot topic amongst laypeople and astrobiologists alike.
So generally when people say to themselves they're alone, they're not considering that there might be microbes living on their skin or in their digestive tract. Because if you want to include them, then you're definitely not alone. There are more microbes in one linear centimeter of your lower colon than all the humans who have ever lived and ever been born on Earth. So you're outnumbered by others who are just sharing your own biological form. So typically when people ask, are we alone, they mean other intelligent life. Are we alone in the universe? And it presumes that we understand intelligence enough to rank ourselves among others in that category that we might discover. And that's, for me, a debatable question. But let's take it as a given that we are intelligent, we're looking for other species with whom we can communicate. We've yet to find any, of course, you would have known about that. But no, we haven't found other life, and we're still not sure how we would.
NASA scientists are encouraging the scientific community to establish a new framework that provides context for findings related to the search for life. They propose creating a scale for evaluating and combining different lines of evidence that would ultimately lead to answering the ultimate question: are we alone in the universe? All of science is a process of asking questions, coming up with hypotheses, developing new methods to look for clues, and ruling out all alternative explanations. Any individual detection may not be completely explained by biological processes and must be confirmed through follow-up measurements and independent investigations. When NASA announced the discovery of Kepler-186f at a press conference back in 2014, people thought that we may have found a planet with alien life. Kepler-186f was described as an Earth-like planet orbiting a nearby star that is both the right size and the right distance from its star to have liquid water on its surface. For obvious reasons, scientists think that liquid water is a key requirement for the development of life. In this case, the planet is only 500 light-years away from Earth. SETI had listened for radio emissions from the Kepler-186 system for about a month, but no signals attributable to extraterrestrial technology were found in that interval. But maybe radio communication is a technology where we think too much inside the box.
So we've got radio communication technology. The good thing about that, of course, is that it can penetrate obscuring gas and dust in space. So we send out a signal using radio waves, or we use radio telescopes to eavesdrop on signals that may be sent our way. But here's an interesting challenge. We surely would have considered ancient Rome a civilization of intelligent people. But had aliens tried to send radio waves to them, no way to receive it, no way to send back, no way to even know what a radio wave is, because the technology had not yet been invented. So our definition of are we alone has to include the fact that they are not only intelligent, but have technology that they can invoke to then send signals across the galaxy. Now, we've only been able to do that for maybe 70 years or so. And most of our original signals that have been sent from Earth were quite by accident. Leakage from early television shows. You know, these are the emissaries of our civilization as we go forward. The first wave of radio communication that would be received by aliens, intelligent aliens in another planet. So watch out for that. Who knows what they're going to think if that's what they're decoding? Because you can't send a signal that we know of faster than the speed of light as radio waves would be sent. So here's my concern, that maybe there was an attempt to communicate with us before we had radio waves, and they concluded that there's no sign of intelligent life on Earth. Suppose not only that, they figured out a cleverer way to communicate than radio waves and radio telescopes, a way that we have yet to invent, because we've only been at it for 70 years. They would still come back with no signal from us. So it's hubristic to even think that what we invent out of the human mind would be the way they would attempt to communicate with us.
Gliese 667 CC is an exoplanet orbiting within the habitable zone of a red dwarf star, a member of the Gliese triple star system, approximately 23 light years away from us. This planet is also known as a super Earth. At least 4.5 times bigger than our own planet, it is likely tidally locked, with one side of its hemisphere permanently facing towards the star, while the opposite side is shrouded in eternal darkness. However, between these two intense areas, there would be a sliver of habitability, called the Terminator Line, where the temperatures may be suitable for liquid water to exist. Thus, this distant alien world could host life as we know it. But perhaps alien life exists much closer to home than we think. To discover the possibilities for past or present life on Mars, NASA's Mars Exploration Program is currently following an exploration strategy known as Seek Signs of Life. This science theme marks a transition in Mars exploration. It reflects a long-term process of discovery on the red planet, built on strategies to understand Mars's potential as a habitat for past or present microbial life. Searching for this answer means delving into the planet's geologic and climate history to find out how, when, and why Mars underwent dramatic changes to become the forbidding yet promising planet we observe today. Around 3.8 billion years ago, Mars and Earth were much more similar. Evidence from Mars missions suggests Mars may have been much warmer and wetter than we observe it to be today. In this ancient time frame, scientists find the first evidence of microbial life on Earth. Did Mars provide similar environmental conditions for life long ago? If microbes were present on Mars in the planet's ancient past, could it exist in special regions today? Scientists are almost certain a vast ocean lies beneath Europa's icy shell. Jupiter's icy moon has the ingredients essential for life: water, chemistry, energy. Scientists predict a salty ocean lies beneath Europa's surface, which has more water than Earth's oceans combined. For Europa to be habitable, it needs to be the essential building blocks for life: carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, sulfur, etc. But how does an icy moon far from the sun get the energy needed to sustain life? Jupiter's strong gravity creates tides on Europa that stretch and tug the moon, producing heat. If there is life in Europa, it almost certainly was completely independent from life on Earth. That must mean the origin of life must be pretty easy throughout the galaxy and beyond.
So now I would say we're probably not alone, and it's going to be damn hard to figure it out. And I say we're probably not alone because just of how long the universe has been around, how many stars there are in the galaxy, and how many galaxies there are in the universe, and how common the ingredients of life are in the universe. So these are fascinating questions that require that we relax the bias that we have as being humans on this planet, just to even ask the question in an answerable way: are we alone?
Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.